Okay, before we get started, I just wanted to do a couple of thank yous. Our trophies are done every year by Jack and Shirley Rumsey. And I'd like to thank our executive. Dan Crawford is the vice president.
Cord DeLint, maybe he's the guy in 10 years is the outstanding Canadian nominee for the CFL. These are kids that I know, and I coached a little bit, and they're great kids, and they got great potential. So dream a little bit. It's there. Canadians can do it in the CFL. So dream. We're ready?
Yep.
All right. Start out with the offensive line. So, first guy. He's a brave, real brave young fella, our offensive lineman, Gus the Meek. Albert, this guy, he's 10 years old, he's playing against 11 and 12 year olds. He's more than holding his weight. He's playing defensive line. He played defensive line too, but offensive line. Playing center, doing long snaps, getting the mark all the time. He's a great man.
Last game, he did 100%.
Did 100%? And you know what? He is a man, because when there's something that he wasn't comfortable with, he was man enough to come and talk to me about things. And that is a real strong, great man, in my opinion. Thanks, guys. Next fella, I think this is the third year that he's played for me, and we've always kind of went, well, sooner or later, Jesse's going to get him. Sooner or later. Well, this year we found Jesse's spot. Jesse is a natural defensive end.
Wow.
And he just really showed himself this year that he could play with anybody, he could play against anybody, and when we needed to play, Jesse was there to stop it. So, good job, Jess. Come on up. Running back receiver, Richie LeGrandier. Well, the next player, it's the third of probably four brothers that I'll get to coach. Mr. Caleb Jones is our defensive star this year. Caleb plays corner for me, and I always say corner is the most difficult position to play on the field because you're out there all on your own. You're the guy that's responsible for anything going outside. And Caleb's always hung in, he listens. When he makes a mistake, he's the first one to say, yeah, I blew it. So Caleb, if you can come up.
You guys all taught me so much about football this year and help this team be so successful. Thank you so much. And Baby, you don't get nearly the recognition you deserve for all the hours you spend in our organization. Here she is working away again. I hope you all enjoyed the season as much as I did. So you guys go out and recruit some friends for next year. We need some more guys. We've got a great thing started here in Pincher, and we need to keep it going. So we'll see you all in the spring.
For this first award is for the defensive lineman of the year. This is the young man who moved up from Pee Wees this year. And he was coached very well there because he worked very well in the Bantams. He loves to tackle. He's aggressive. And he gave many quarterbacks nightmares. Austin Bruder.
This next award
always quick to attack, and able to get in position from the other teams and direct their plans. Tyler Revere. This is an award for the defensive star. We put this guy in just about every position we had. He was a fullback, a slot back, a linebacker, a quarterback, and a kicker. When a big tackle happened out on the field, and the dust cleared, he was generally in on it.
This young man was an inspiration to us all. He showed up ready to play every day with a positive attitude and willingness to learn. It didn't matter if it was raining, snowing, or gale force pitch or winds, there was always a twinkle in his eye. Team spirit, Bryce Crawford.
There we go. next kid was late for this supper too. Like he's late for every single practice. It doesn't matter how many hills we made him run. It took his time. Poor kid was so small. And some of those big, messy mat kids. You could hear him. If it was 120 kilometer winds, you could hear him. You heard it.
Chasing the opposition down the field for a tackle at our end zone, he was the man for the job. He was double and triple teamed for much of the season as the other teams got the scouting reports on him. Even with that amount of pressure, he still showed incredible skill and heart to get the job done. Ben Revere.
Tell you, we scared the heck out of Willow Creek that year.
And Kate Andrews.
So I'm very happy to have them as part of the team. And finally, but certainly not least, Todd Merrick has joined us with the kicking program. And results speak for themselves. We have an incredible kicking program. We have incredible kickers. We have Cord that won an MVP in the league for place kicking. We had a 43-yarder at McMahon Stadium in an earlier game. That's a pretty impressive kick. And we've had Corey and Lane both punting the ball with a formation that was a contribution of Wayne's with our gunners, and we've scored a touchdown off that, recovered balls with that. It's something to give other teams nightmares, and so between Todd and the rest of our coaches, they've really done a great job to help us see what needs to be improved and working towards that. So thank you very much, guys, for coming home. Last year we said we needed three things to go to provincials. We needed more dedication from the players in terms of being there, being working hard, being at practice. We wanted them to work off season, and we said we could sure use some extra bodies. Well, hey, maybe two out of three ain't bad. The most important part of this presentation is the presentation of the trophy to the individual award winners. I just want to reiterate some of the benchmarks that our boys have done this year. Best winning season in our history, 7-2. Those two losses were a total of 2 points in actuality. Refs can't give points on a fail, on a penalty in the end zone, on a convert. But anyway, 2 points were the only two losses of the season. So just an incredible season in terms of wins and losses. Ranked in the top positions all season long. In fact, we were number one more than any other team in the province. That, again, is recognition of what these boys have done and how hard they've worked on the field and what heart they have. Also, of course, the trophy itself speaks for itself, and being in provincials for the first time ever. I think that's quite an accomplishment for a young man. Okay, at this time, I would like to begin the awards by mentioning that Coach Alexander and I have donated an award. We felt that we were just missing one award that we felt that would kind of complement what we're recognizing tonight. And we haven't set a criteria in stone because each year it may change. We've donated an award, we're just calling it the Coach's Award. And I'll let Wayne do the honors of presenting it.
I have to tell you that my 2 years here have been absolutely great. I've really enjoyed the football program. There isn't enough said to the coaches of Beattie and Banton. They've done a wonderful job in bringing these players to the forefront and helping us get to where we are. The Coaches Award is a new category that the coaches decided to award this year. It's based on to acknowledge a player who has the ability to lead on the field, can bridge the gap in communication between coaches and players, can keep calm in all situations. This year we have selected two players who possess these qualities. Both of these players have shown huge changes from last year. Both have matured as football players and have accepted a greater role on and off the field. I'm extremely proud and fond of these boys and know that their calm demeanor tomorrow may well make the difference on a snowy field 4 hours north of here. We are venturing into enemy territory when we step on the field in Drumheller. I know that these two recipients will handle the pressure with class, a quiet confidence, and that those were instrumental in this year's success, and they will do all in their power to bring us to another milestone to win our first provincial playoff win. The winners this year of the Coaches Award are Number 10, Court Dillon on defense. And number 12, Gabe Brainford.
Spirit Warden, Nick McIntosh, Spirit Warden. I'm not an Asian person, so just be patient, please. Nick McIntosh, he played football. He actually played with my brother. He's a tremendous player. A lot of heart. He was a very good football player, dedicated, never gave up. Very good, solid football player. And he was taken before his time. But his spirit lives on through this award. And the gentleman for this award this year, he was like Nick. I don't think I ever heard him get down on himself or on other players. He kept chugging along. He's never a big flashy guy. He worked. He worked hard. He was dedicated. He did his job. He did it tremendously through hurt. And he got a couple good hits on him this year. And scared me a couple times. But just a tremendous player, this young gentleman is. Lane Crawford.
All right, this next award is going to our special teams player of the year. This guy worked real hard. He's a core member of the team, and me being his coach for kicking a couple off too. But he did a great job, and I brought this award to Court Reliant. He was arguing with me, well, him not deserving a kicking award, but yeah, he was so good, he deserved it. Wait, humble.
The next trophy is most dedicated. It's given to a player who always is at practice because he wants to be there. It's not to please us, it's because he wants to be there. He plays football because he loves the sport, not because somebody asked him to. He likes to run because he likes to be in shape, not because somebody else thinks it's a good thing for him to do. He sees his role as more than just about himself. He sees the bigger picture, that he is a part of a group of young men chasing a common dream. This year's recipient has all of those qualities and many more. He leads through example. He is a role model for all players. He mentors the younger players. This determined and self-driven player trains not just in football season, but all year round. His hard work has paid off in personal football awards at the league level. In the 2 years I have been here, he has not missed a practice, a game, or a single minute due to an injury of any kind. He understands the connection to the words success and dedication. For that reason, he is not only a pleasure to coach, but he has a wonderful future ahead of him. How do you spell most dedicated? I spell it G-I-N-G-E-R.
Through anything. He's a skilled, strong, dedicated. It's a joy to watch this guy play football. On offense, on defense, wherever you wanted him, he played it. He offered to play tight end. He probably played quarterback if he could, if we let him. Without saying that anymore, Alex Oliver.
His big linemen like Mr. Oliver there and Eddie Manyguns, and all of a sudden just squirting out into the open and he is gone. And if anybody was an announcer in the booth, he would be a dream player for them. And he breaks away and he's down the field and he's not going to get caught and it's a touchdown! Braden Berger! Privilege and honor to award this year's MVP award. We have so many boys with talent on this team. It's never an easy choice picking one over others. This young man has been so critical on both sides of the ball for us. He has blocked and cleared a path for our outstanding and league all-star running back. He has carried the ball himself and broken off his own long runs. He has made a difference on defense wherever we put him. And he certainly has created all kinds of problems for opposing offenses because they just can't get around him or through him or reversing past him. And this young man has just been a standout in so many respects. On the field, off the field, a classy guy, a communicator. He just breathes the game in the sense that he understands what it takes to be a superior athlete and to be a success on the field. And I don't think anybody would disagree with this pick as MVP, and that is Mr. Stephen Hoxton. Times are tough, and that's when we really find out what we're all about as people. When times get tough, we come back together and we start building that energy again, and we start preparing for the next battle, and that's what these guys are all about. So I'd like to thank the parents for your support, for that driving back and forth, for those changes in home schedules and sacrifices. Without you, these boys wouldn't be where they are. And this program wouldn't be where it is. So thank you very, very much.
I forgot to say, there's a guy, the Bantam team here, that's an amazing guy. He won the MVP for our team here. I'm going to be nominating him to go down and play for a team that goes out to Canada. It's coached by the defensive coordinator from the University of British Columbia. So if you guys give him the best of luck to make the team. They go down to Texas and it's for a week-long workshop and stuff, and they play the Texas team. So give Ben your best regards and hope that he makes the team.
Get in touch with me and we'll get you on your way.